There's a district, Palm Springs School District, out in California, and some years back, they were using our product on a regular basis, and all of a sudden, without notice, we stopped getting orders. And I was curious as to what had happened, but I knew that I was going to be seeing my contact from the school district in a couple of weeks at a show, and so I didn't do anything. I waited, figured I'd wait to see them in person. Well, right before I went to the show, we got a new open purchase order in, and it was for somewhere around four times the original amount. I got to the show and I asked Tammy, I said, what happened? And she said, well, we got a new director in, and the new director decided to essentially change the menus almost completely. And one of the things that got taken off were our crybaby cups. And there was an eight-year-old girl who got every single kid in the school to sign a petition to bring the crybabies back. You know, she went and she did something about it. And what she did something about was our product. You know, it was the thing that we created, and it was just such a cool feeling. And not only did they put it back on, but instead of doing it once a month, they started doing it once a week. And we've been doing business with them ever since.
A valedictorian in a school district in Texas, at one point in the midst of a wonderful speech, he gave a shout out about the days in which we were young and crybaby was our greatest moment in our day. And the whole crowd, when he said that, began to cheer and clap and celebrate in agreement that that experience as a kid followed through from kindergarten through their 12th grade of being excited about getting to go have lunch in their schools.
We do a traditional side of our product that's sold in ice cream companies and also ice cream trucks. And in the summer and spring, we have an ice cream truck that comes through here, and of course they have our Rosati Ice product in it, and the kids in the neighborhood, they always seem to go to the truck, and I constantly get photos of them eating our product. And I just actually got one from a neighbor of mine who went to Florida 2 weeks ago. Lo and behold, she was on the beach and went to a little ice cream truck and pulled out a Rosati Ice cup and took a photo and sent it to me. So I thought that was really, really neat.
One day we get this phone call from a woman, and she says, when I was in school, my friends and I, we sat at lunch together. We were best friends, and we always talked about getting crybaby t-shirts. And she said it was something we never did. Our friend is getting married, and we want to surprise her by getting some crybaby t-shirts for the bachelorette party. You know, is there any way that we could purchase them? She said, I won't even charge you for them. I'll send them out to you. I said, one request, send us an appropriate, please, picture from the bachelorette party of you guys wearing the t-shirts. And she said, absolutely, no problem, thanks so much. So we sent enough for the bride and the bridesmaids, and we never got a picture back. And it was months later, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, we get this picture, and it wasn't from the bachelorette party, it was from the wedding. And here's the bride in her wedding dress, and the maid of honor and the bridesmaids all in their beautiful dresses with these bright green crybaby t-shirts pulled over top of them, and taking a picture for us. For me, it's stories like that. It makes you realize that the impact that it's having on the kids long term, the impact that it's having on them both socially and and otherwise, it's way bigger than we had any idea of, right? So I always love that story.